Were there any emotions in particular that you wrestled with in leaving your children to perform for an extended period of time?
Again, I think I felt more guilt about my husband than I did my children, because I do believe that it's just a natural time to pull away from your husband and bond with your children, because they, first of all, they need you for sustenance. I breastfed both of my children. Your husband doesn't need you for sustenance that way, or else you have a very weird relationship. But I felt a little he was neglected, but I never felt like my children were. I had the perfect job in that I could be home at 11 o'clock every morning and still get to all their little plays and their little, many of their doctor's appointments and, you know, just play dates and things like that. I think you have to, you can't choose, I guess, your careers in that sense. I mean, I was already doing what I did when I had my children, but you adapt to it. You know, if say I had an opportunity to be at a big party, I mean, we lived in Connecticut, so say I did the show in New York, went home, was at all the kids' school stuff, and then had to go be back in the city for something that evening, it had to be something very, very extraordinary for me to go back to the city again and spend a night away from them. Because I just think that it's time you'll never have back. And when I put something off for quite a while. I was asked years ago by Julie Andrews to take over for her on Broadway one night a week so that she could have a little better rest period. When she was doing Victor Victoria. And that's pretty heady stuff for a woman who's wanted to be on Broadway since she could say the word Broadway. Here was my chance, and to have somebody like a Julie Andrews think highly enough of me to say, I trust you with this, even if it's just for one show a week. My daughter was one at the time, and I said to her, I said, I can't believe I'm saying no to Mary Poppins. But my daughter is 1 year old, and she'll only be one now. And Broadway will always be there, and I hope you understand, but I have to say no. And she was so lovely. She goes, you know, Kathy, I so understand it. I had to make those same kind of decisions about my own children when they were young. And she said, I've discovered that you'll never regret putting your children first. You'll always regret when you don't. So 7 years later, Carol Burnett asked me to do the same thing. By that time, my daughter was eight, and it was time. And I never regretted the decision ever at all, and it worked out beautifully. In fact, my daughter was there opening night for me on Broadway. So that's just an illustration of the choices you make along the way. If you listen to that still small voice that's inside your gut, where we really all live, but we rarely listen to it, it will always guide you the right way. It's when we ignore that still small voice that we get into trouble.